I absolutely think it's a policy that needs to stand firm in terms of keeping a stormwater pollution mitigation approach on the books. Like anything, the devil's in the details, and implementation is the most important part of governing. And I think we had to start in a place where the largest jurisdictions that were contributing most of the problems had to be addressed, but this should very likely be reviewed to determine what other jurisdictions should be brought to the table to continue contributing to the solution. In order for us to fully tackle the problem of our ailing Chesapeake Bay, we've determined that there are three key areas we have to stay on top of. One of them is stormwater management, one is wastewater management, and the third is agricultural pollution. And we've taken great steps with both stormwater and wastewater management at the legislative level. We have a long way to go still on agricultural runoff, and that's a focus that I have brought attention to in this campaign and proposals that we should investigate. The last report card that came out on the health of the bay, showing it to be a C scorecard, and none of us are going to be happy about it being a C. One place where it showed improvement was in some of the stormwater management for some of the tributaries that are coming into the bay, but we still have a long way to go. And working with the jurisdictions to meet these goals is key. The implementation phase, where I think the biggest failure was in communicating. The law was on the books for 2 years before it went into communication, and if we had done a better job of proactively working with local jurisdictions to talk about the reason why it was passed, the result of what we benefit from having it in place, the fact that it was also driven by our compliance with a federal lawsuit from the EPA on fulfilling our goals and obligations on keeping our total daily maximum loads into the bay under control of a certain threshold, then we would have done a better job of having people understand that we all have a stake to play in keeping the bay clean, and that our pesticides that run off our lawns and into the storm drains don't just vanish. They're going into the Chesapeake Bay, and they're choking off our grasses, and they're killing the ecological health of the bay to be able to clean itself. And instead, the opposition was allowed to get out in front of defining it and putting it in terms of a rain tax, when really it's a tax on concrete and impervious surfaces. And I think that when we're more focused on the unglamorous side of actually governing and having the intended benefits of these proposals be put in place, we're going to be better served.